ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. And, of course, the makers of Horlicks tablets, too. Don't forget that. Horlicks tablets are especially handy in summer. Let me give you one example. Here's a wire from a friend on a motoring trip out west who promised to drop me a line. Reached 2,000 miles today, still going strong. Tablets swell. Quite a trip by the sound of it. But you don't have to travel 2,000 miles to enjoy Horlicks tablets. They're just as useful on weekend rides. They help keep you refreshed, keep your appetite satisfied if you can't get your meals when you want them. Or if it's golf you prefer, or hikes in the woods, you will still find a flask of Horlicks tablets great to have along. Get a 10-cent handy pocket flask from your druggist. He has them also in larger sizes, if you wish, in either natural or chocolate flavor. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. It's beginning to look as though that little fall Squire Skimp had a few days ago may turn into a serious bump for Lum and Abner. The old fellows received notice from his attorneys yesterday that he was bringing suit for personal injury against the Pine Ridge Planetarium for $1,000 in damages. As we look in on Pine Ridge today, we find Lum and Abner over at the Jot 'em Down store in a serious discussion with Dick Huddleston. Listen.
Sir, I still don't see how he could expect to collect no damages from us. We never pushed him down or nothing. Ain't our fault if he's so awkward he can't walk down the aisle over there without falling down.
Well, he received those injuries near the theater, though, Lum. That makes you and Abner liable.
What's a what, Dick?
You're liable. You know nothing about law matters at all. And what, Dick?
Well, it just looks to me like he's got a pretty good case against you if he takes it to court.
Well, he's going to take it to court, all right. Ain't no doubts about that. That letter we got from them lawyers yesterday said they was bringing suit again.
Well, what I mean, though, Lum, if I was you, I'd get hold of Squire and have a talk with him. See if he can't affect the settlement out of court.
You mean just pay him something and not take it to court, huh?
Well, I don't like to advise you on those things, but that's what I'd do. I believe you'd save money back, because if it goes to court, why, you've got the expense of the trial, and you're more likely to lose it anyway.
Well, I don't believe he's half as bad hurt as he's letting on like he is in the first place.
No.
Doc Miller says he examined him all over, and he can't find a thing wrong with him. Squire claims his spinal columns is hurt.
Yeah, and that's the trouble, too. I was talking with Doc Miller about that this morning. He says that there's no way to tell about an injury in the back that way. Squire more than likely knew that when he claims that's where he was hurt.
You mean Squire knowed he's going to get hurt in his back before he fell down?
Well, yes, Abner, I wouldn't be surprised. Just looked to me like that this whole, hey, had this whole thing figured out before he came to the show that night. Didn't you tell me yesterday, Lum, that you tried to pass him in free that night and he insisted on paying?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I told him we never wanted to charge him nothing. Told him he's welcome to come over there anytime he wanted to and see the show free. But he laid a quarter down and wouldn't take it back at all, so he paid.
Well, you see, he wanted to be sure and pay his way so he could be classed as a paid customer.
Yeah.
He's got a better case against you that way.
Well, I'll be dead blamed. I'm beginning to see through the whole thing now, I believe.
Well, I can't see why he'd want to run them chances. Come over and hit his head against one of them seats and knock himself unconsciousness just to try to collect $1,000.
Well, that's just it, Abner. He might not even hit his head. Might not have been hurt at all. Just letting on like he was.
Well, he couldn't have been as bad hurt as he let on, or he couldn't have got up out of bed Wednesday to go into the county seat to see those lawyers.
Yeah, that did look strange, didn't it?
Yeah, I thought about that. I thought about something that day. It might have been the day before, though. Nothing.
Well, why don't you call him up, Lum? Have a talk with him. See if you can get this thing settled. Might be able to settle with him for just a doctor bill or something like that.
Yeah.
And if you can, well, I believe you'd be money ahead.
Trouble is, I don't know hardly what to say to him.
Well, let me talk to him. I'll tell him what I think about it. And I won't beat around the bush about it, neither.
No. We got to be careful now. Sure don't want to say nothing that's going to make him any madder than he is.
Yeah, that just makes him that much harder to settle with.
I'll call him up and see if I can get him to come over here. Let's see. He's short and alone. We can try to reason with him.
Yeah, that'd be better if you can get him over here, Lum.
Hey, you stay over here and help us talk to him, Dave.
No, I'd rather not get mixed up in it, Abner. I'd be glad to help you fellas all I can, but you better do the talking to him yourself.
Hello?
Yeah.
Skimpsy's face? Is the Squire there, Mrs. Skimp? I asked him to step to the phone, please, Mom. All right, I'll hold it.
So that's why he's been acting so nice here late. Just a snake in wolf's clothes, that's who he is. Him and his fancy watch fob.
Hello, Squire. Why, this here's Lum Edwards.
Me and Abner got a letter from them lawyers there in the county seat yesterday, that Clark, Clark, and Clark outfit.
Sound like old setting man, Clark, Clark, and Clark.
Yeah.
That's what Cedric is, he's a Clark in the floor.
Well, if you want our honest opinions, we never liked it. And that's what I'm calling you up about. They said you were suing us for $1,000 for getting hurt over at the picture show. Well, we'd like to talk it over with you. I wonder if you wouldn't like to drop over here for a few minutes. Well, good. Well, we'll be looking for you. All right, Sparks. He'd be right over.
Well, that's fine. Now, when he gets over there, why, well, tell him that you want to do the right thing about it, and I'd offer to pay him for any loss of time and take care of the doctor bills and such as that.
Yeah, that won't amount to much. See, he weren't in bed more than a couple of days there.
Well, I don't think Doc Miller ought to charge nothing at all if he never found a thing wrong with him.
Well, that ain't Doc's fault.
Yeah, I know, but if it had been old Doc Rowlands over at Cherry Hill, well, he'd have found something wrong with him.
Why, Doc Rowlands is a veteran, a horse doctor.
I know it. I seen him examine a horse once, and he couldn't find out what was wrong with it, and he give it some medicine to make it half collie.
He couldn't find out what was wrong with the horse, so he give him some medicine to make him have the collie.
Yeah, see, he knowed how to cure the collie.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Well, that sounds about old Doc Rowland.
Yeah.
I wish Doc Miller had to give Squire something like that.
Yeah, I do, too.
Well, I expect I better be going, though. Squire ought to be here directly.
Well, Jake, don't stretch off now.
No, I've got to go along.
Well, we sure thank you for your advice. I don't know what we would do if we never had you to lean again in time of trouble.
Oh, well, that's all right, Lum. I'm afraid I'm not much help on this. Well, let me know how you come out with him, though.
Oh, yeah, I'll run over to your store there quick as we get through talking with him.
Well, good luck to you.
Yeah, much obliged.
Yeah, so long. I go get that mixed all right fella, you know.
Oh, yeah, he's fine.
Yeah.
Now, Abner, when Squire gets here, you better let me do the talking. You know how high-strung you are. All this drapping and losing your temper. You say something and then file everything.
Yeah, I do fly off in the handle terrible, don't I?
That's what I say.
Yeah, I might forget myself and scare him clean out of here. Just jump on him and beat the everlasting daylights out of him. That's my trouble. I don't know my own strength. I'd hurt him so bad we'd have to pay him $2,000 this time. Maybe three, I don't know. I get some dad.
Wait a minute. Here he comes.
Now, don't tell him what I said, now. I might make him mad.
I won't.
But, you know, if he got mad, he might not want to settle it out of court, don't you see?
Yeah, I see.
Besides, I was pretty mad, and a fella will say things when he gets mad that way they don't have meaning. I might not have meant none of it. So if I was you, I don't believe I'd say nothing to him about it.
I told you I weren't going to say nothing about it. Fact is, I never even paid no attention to what you were saying.
Well, good. It wouldn't do no good, no.
Wait a minute. Here he is. Well, howdy, Squire.
Hello, Squire, old boy. Glad to see you.
Come on back and sit down.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, man.
How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm gradually getting my strength back on.
You're looking fine.
Yes, I guess I look a whole lot better than I feel. As a narrow escape I had there. You'll never know how I suffered. I wouldn't go through that again for $10,000.
I thought you'd just ask $1,000.
Shut up, Abner.
What was you wanted, Lum? You know I'm a busy man. My time's valuable.
Well, we got that letter from your lawyer yesterday saying you're suing us for $1,000, and I just thought we could all three sort of get together and talk it over and settle it out of court, maybe.
Yeah.
Me and Abner wants to do the right thing about it. We're just as sorry as we can be that it had to happen.
Well, being sorry, Lum, won't mend my shattered nerves, you know. I feel that I've offered a very generous settlement. If you men hadn't been such old friends of mine, I'd never settle for such a paltry sum.
Well, Squire, $1,000 is a lot of money, special to me and Abner. We want to do what's right, but we're getting along in years, getting old. It'd just be about all we could do to scrape up that much money. And if we did, it'd mean giving up our picture show or our store here once.
You don't want to take the case to court, Lum?
Well, we figured we could save hiring a lawyer and all that if we could settle with you out of court.
Mm-hmm.
We're willing to pay your doctor bill and pay for what time you've lost if you figure it's worth anything.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do then. Us being such old friends, I don't want to hold you men up. I've instructed my attorneys to ask for $1,000 settlement. But if you men are sincere and want to settle this thing out of court, give me a third interest in your picture show over there and make me manager, and we'll just call the whole thing even.
No.
We told you once we didn't want you for a partner in that picture show.
Yeah.
Well, all right, then. We'll take it to court.
Well, we'll take it to court, then. I don't believe you can collect no damages. It wasn't our fault you fell down and hurt yourself nohow.
Well, I don't think I'll have any trouble proving that it was your fault. Maybe you've forgotten about that little note that you sent me when I was still in bed over there.
Oh, no, I recollect writing a little note telling you we're sorry.
Yeah, wait a minute. Let me read you this note and see if it'll refresh your memory.
Yeah.
Says, Dear Squaw, we are awfully sorry you got hurt when you fell down in our picture show last night. We feel bad about it, because we know it's our fault for not having more lights in there so that you could see where you was going. Anything we can do for you, be sure and let us know, for we feel responsible for the whole business. And both of you signed it.
Well, I'll be glad to glad.
Well, it looks like it was no idle threat when Squire swore he'd get even with Lum and Abner for closing up his theater.
I am overweight.
So am I. How can we cut down?
Use the Horlick weight control plan.
What would I have to do?
Cut out your usual big lunch. Drink Horlick's malted milk instead.
Well, how does it work?
Horlick contains less calories than any ordinary heavy meal.
What are calories?
The measure of the fuel value of food.
How does that affect my weight?
When the body gets more fuel than it needs, the excess food may be turned into fat.
But is a glass of Horlick's at noon sufficient?
Yes. Horlick's is a well-balanced food and a good source of the minerals and vitamins essential for providing correct and sustaining nourishment.
Has the plan ever been officially tested?
Yes, by 25 women in a supervised test. It was found that they lost on an average more than 3.5 pounds in 3 weeks.
Where can we get Horlick's malted milk?
At any druggist, in either natural or chocolate flavor. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlick's, who now bid you all good night and good health.